Dang. All right, here we go. All right. Well, what's up, everybody? GrimmGreen back here today. Thank you so much for joining me again. I feel a little bit rusty, if I'm being honest. I've basically been gone the entire month of February. But I'm back now, feeling super energized, and today we're going to talk about the MikeVapes Clutch Mech Mod. I got this clutch just a few days before I went on my big 1 month long vacation. And I have essentially been using it every single day that I have been gone. This clutch recoil RDA combo was literally the one single cloud chasey type of setup that I took with me to Amsterdam. From the moment that I got this clutch and I kind of put a battery in it and I put it in my hands, I thought, well, I'm in love. MikeVapes teamed up with Dovpo, teamed up with Signature Tips to release this beautiful little mech mod. And when I say little, it's really small. This is a 21700 mech mod, and it is substantially smaller than I think every 21700 mech mod that I have. I mean, that's the height of it right there next to the Kennedy 28, which is a 21700 as well. And if I line up the bottoms, you can see even without the atomizer attached, the clutch is much shorter. There's the Keen right there from Mr. Stan Tenacious TX Vapes. Mine happens to just look like a dull roll of pennies, but as you can see, it's smaller. I mean, it's substantially shorter. And even as the width goes, it's not much bigger than a tube mech mod. And I guess there's that Mech Life 21700, the Arcless from Mech Life, still taller than this mech. I've always honestly just been a fan of the Signature Tip stuff. When they hit me up about a year, 2 years ago to do those Grimm Army, you know, SQ squonkers, I was on board instantly. I love their products. And you can see right there that the clutch kind of maintains that Signature Tips look to it. You know, it's got that same box design, the same button design on the front, and that same like grippy ergonomic design for your fingers. The only problem is you don't exactly hold this like you hold other SQ mods. With a box mod and a squonker, you have these like, you know, finger cutouts, right? So you can kind of grab it in your hand, like full palm grab it and then hit the button with your finger. You can kind of full palm grab this clutch and then hit the button with your finger like this, but what I have found with the clutch that makes it just so beautifully ergonomic is it's just a fingertip mod. It's just a fingertip device. It's just fingertips all the time. You never really get it into your palm and grab it, you know, like you would with a traditional tube mech. It's all in the fingertips, just fingertips on here. And you kind of hit the button with your finger. You can flip it around easily, hit the button with your thumb, but it's all handled in the fingertip area. Or, my friends, you can hold this in the single most comfortable position of all time, and that is what I call, and what a lot of people have called, the bad mitten technique. The clutch mod. Your thumb kind of goes along the back right here, and then you kind of just wrap your fingers around, and you kind of end up holding it like a fucking badminton racket. Really comfortable. I've been on YouTube for 10 years talking about how I love to hit the fire button with my finger. The clutch comes through, hit the fire button with my finger, like just awesome. Everything I want in a little mechanical box. Full silver contacts on the inside, hits nice and hard. And in addition to that, it's got a cool little lock feature as well. And these doors are magnetically attached. Both doors are held on by magnets. They hold on real well when you're using it, but they pop off real easy when you need to get access to your battery. There is only one way for the doors to go on. There is a back door. This goes against your battery. And there is a front door with the logo on it that will go across the front of your battery. Now this is the part that might be difficult to see, but you can see when I press the button, there's just a little contact right there that's gonna go ahead and hit that other tiny little contact. It's gonna complete the circuit. That's just silver on silver right now, which again makes it hit nice and hard. And my favorite thing is it's an effortless press. It's not a wrench it down kind of mech. There's some mechs out there in tube or box mode otherwise that you have to really kind of crank down, like really press those contacts together. This is just the lightest little feather touch. You kind of press it and it just consistently fires every single time and hits hard every single time. And as I mentioned, there's just a little lock right here. So you can kind of see this little number right here. It's facing down. That means it's unlocked. You can kind of turn this up and that locks the switch. So when you press that really light feathery button, it's not going to fire. It's just a cool little safety feature added in there that I really enjoy and really appreciate and have used quite a bit in my travels. One little trick that I've been doing to kind of get the battery in and out easier is you kind of have to back off your RDA about 3 or 4 spins, and then the battery's gonna come out nice and easy. There's no need on this clutch to be jamming your battery in and out of it. Just back off your RDA, you're good. And this isn't like any sort of spring-loaded battery thing, so you don't put in like at the top and then slide the bottom in, or push the bottom in and slide the top in. You kind of grab your battery like this and just slide it straight in. Just boop, straight in. Crank down your atomizer, that's gonna help hold your battery in place. Doors go back on effortlessly. I mean, what am I, I'm just gonna sit here and gush about this clutch. I literally can find 0 faults with this thing. I love it from top to bottom. Dovpo in China did all of the manufacturing on this. I know Signature Tips in the UK did all of the quality control on this, and with Mike designing it, like, that's just win, win, win. So let's get down to brass tacks here. Are you gonna need your vape budget hands? If you wanna check out the clutch, Mech Mod, MikeVapes, Dovpo, Signature Tips. Yeah, but kinda, but not really. The clutch clocks in at about $90. So not like crazy vape budget hands, but some vape budget hands are needed. Now, if we were going to play the Aliens game or the FDA game, where they have come and taken everything I have and I have nothing left to vape, is the clutch Mech Mod something I'm gonna seek out and buy right away? Here's the thing, yes, because I haven't been this stoked on a Mech Mod in a while. Don't get me wrong, I'm a big fan of tube mechs. You know, I like the Kennedys, I like my Stan Tenacious TX vape stuff, I like my unicorn Mech Mods, but I like Mech Mods that are outside of the box, which is one of the reasons I love that Aspen Modco Monarch so much. It's a dual parallel 2700 box with a clicky button. It's unique. The clutch is a single 21700 aluminum machined mech box thing. It's just really unique and I really, really like it. So yeah, I'm definitely gonna say yes to the FDA game, to the Aliens game. I love a good mech, and I haven't been this excited or this stoked on a mech in a long time. It's just nice and refreshing to see some of these designs, like this mech design, kind of literally outside of the box. Outside of the box, because it's a box, right? Anyway, let's wrap this up. Truly and honestly, the clutch is just rocking. I just love it. If you're in the market for a new mod and you're looking to eyeball a mechanical mod, I would suggest you direct your eyeballs directly to the clutch Mech Mod. I have one. I got this one for no charge for the purpose of doing this video, but I instantly want to buy more. I would like a black one maybe, or a blue one if he does blue, because then, oh, you could swap out the doors. You could get a green one with black doors, put black doors on, you get a black one with green door, green doors on it. So many matching possibilities. Anyway, that's what I got for today, everybody. Thank you so much for joining me again. Feels good to be back. I'll see you guys on Tuesday for Tuesday Bro Tuesday. But that's what I got. Okay, it's the clutch. No links are allowed in the description because of YouTube, so you're gonna have to use your Google Foo, but thank you again so much for watching, you guys. And no matter what anybody tells you, especially that Mike Bloomberg, you always, let's always keep on vaping. Always keep on vaping.